Well, we are at our final chapel service for the 2016-2017 academic year, and I can't believe it. It's such a beautiful day. We're so grateful to have each and every one of you here today to celebrate. Most of all, we had a special invitation to our seniors, so let's give our seniors a round of applause. This will be their final chapel service. And sadly to say, this will be my last chapel service as manager of chapel programs, but I still will be on campus. So while I'm sad that I have to leave this place, I will be sure to continue to be a part of the chapel community, and I'll be just across the promenade. So I'll still be here. One thing I wanted to do during this service, I want to call up Sarah. Are you here? Where's Sarah? Come on, Sarah. Everybody give Sarah a round of applause. Before we begin our service, I want to give Sarah the opportunity to talk about something that's very exciting, something that Preston and I are very proud of our students for putting together, Infinite Space. And I will let her give a little bit of background about it, and then she will also read a piece out of this publication that has just been published. So, Sarah, I'm going to give you the mic, and we will move along with the program.
Hello, I'm Sarah Leonard. And once again, this is Infinite Space, which is a student-ran publication that was recently published, and you can get a copy on the way out. But what it is, it's composed of stories, poetry, photos, art, and it's all from students and what they believe, what their view or what form presence is to them. So once again, this year is presence, and each year would be a different theme, and it's all by students, and what their stories, their tales, how it changed them, how God changed them. And yeah, so if you want to get a copy on the way out, you, right out there it'll be. And we will have an unveiling ceremony at 7 after. And if you want to help, if there's any students who aren't graduating, who are interested in helping out with the publication next year, there will also be a sign-up sheet on that little, right back there, yeah. So I'm going to be reading Sarah Colbert's piece, because she can't be here today, and I mean, what better than Sarah to read Sarah's, so. It's called Work in Progress. My life is not a chapter book, confined to neat pages, held together with glue. My life is not in coherent lines, concise and tailored, submitted for review. My life is crumpled rough drafts, run on sentences and typos. My life doesn't thrill you with epic battles between foes. My life is a free verse, stream of consciousness, collection of mistakes, of leaps and falls. My story is that of the plea, no princess, no hero, just a singular green dot, unassuming and too small. I am the grain that's between growing all along, who by faith became a tree with a story and a song. So, if you want to, oh, thank you. If you want to hear more stories like that and hear more about Infinite Space, once again, after chapel, there will be a ceremony where this will be unveiled just downstairs. Thank you.
As always, let's take a few deep breaths. And I think today, instead of taking two, I can tell by the tension in the air with exams and sort of being almost finished but not quite, I think today we need three deep breaths. So we're going to start off by taking a deep breath. And for those that this may be your very first chapel service, this is something that we do to center ourselves during weekly worship, to do what I like to call shaking ourselves off, shaking the issues and the worries and the anxieties off, and centering ourselves on God and centering ourselves on worship. So join me in taking our first deep breath. Let's take another. Let's take one more. Let us center our hearts and our minds on worship.
Lord, thank you for this day, and thank you for everything you've given us. I pray that you would bless us seniors as we go off to wherever we're going, jobs or more school or wherever. I pray for exams that you would help everyone to not be stressed out, and I pray that the message tonight would really touch everyone's hearts. And please join me in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever.
Good evening.
There
we go. I like that. All right. Our opening hymn today is number 117, Our God, Our Help in Ages Past. And I personally enjoy this hymn because all of us go to God whenever we have our troubles, whenever we have our strifes come against us. And we know that he's been through us a lot in the past and know that he's going to help us for years to come.
So you'll see six verses on this hymn, but we're only going to do four of them. So we're all going to start off singing the first one, and then just the ladies are going to do the second one, then just the men on verse number five, and then everyone together again on number six. So we'll go ahead and begin. You can stand up and join us.
But I'm going to go ahead and since Molly shifted and we already did the Lord's Prayer and we shifted that, we're already flexible tonight. I want to welcome our senior awardees up. So if Genesis Gospel Choir will come up and also Jordan Green and y'all can go on down. Y'all did wonderful. And who's the other one? Lexi Williams, if I'll come up. Every year we give awards out of the chapel. One of our awardees tonight, Tiffany Jones, can't be here. She won the Outstanding Dedication to the Chapel Award. But our other awards are Outstanding Senior to the Board of Stewards, which is Jordan Green and Lexi Williams. An award we've started giving out every year is to recognize a campus ministry to the work they do on campus and beyond our campus that shows the best side of High Point University, those who have come to serve others and to live into the way of Christ. And so this year's the recipient is Genesis Gospel Choir. Thank you. And I was going to say, would y'all give them a round of applause, but you've done that very, very well. So now, at this time, would you turn to one another and them and welcome one another with the peace of Christ.
guys can be seated. All right, well, as you just heard, my name is Jordan Green, and on behalf of the Board of Stewards, I'd like to welcome you all to the last chapel service of the year. I'm just up here to talk to you a little bit about the offering that's going to come around, and if you've been with us for a few weeks, you know that the offering is going towards buying bus passes for the women at Leslie's house, which is in High Point, and so we have this whole semester collected about $1,500, which is amazing, and it's going to be such a big help. Yeah. So tonight, as the last chapel service of the year, I ask that you give as generously as you can so that we can push that even farther and get even more people the assistance and the support that they need to really live out an amazing life, and so that we can touch the High Point community even more than we have already this year. So thank you very much, and please give as generously as you can.
Y'all can leave them.
Hi, would you please join me in prayer? Loving God, I thank you for all that you've done for us throughout this year. I thank you for how you've kept us and how you've held us and how you've been our peace in times of stress and struggle. God, I thank you for all that you will do in us and through us this summer. God, I ask you to move in us and just to be with us. I pray for the seniors as they're leaving this place or staying at this place or doing whatever they're doing, God, that you continue to walk beside them and hold them in the palm of your hand. Bless the service tonight, and let us just reflect and remember all you've been this year. God, in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Would the Board of Stewards seniors come up, and Ashley Russell from Chapel Choir. So a little different tonight. I'm going to read scripture, and then usually I preach each week, but this week the seniors are going to join me, and they're going to be telling about where they've seen God move in this place and in their lives during this time and looking forward. And as they're finishing coming up, just Dr. Dobler, are y'all going to be singing at Baccalaureate? Oh, my gosh. Can y'all give Chapel Choir a round of applause? So that's a reinterpretation of John Wesley's covenant prayer, I believe, which is, gosh, if you like had a daily mantra, like make that your daily mantra. It's absolutely beautiful. What else? I was going to bring up something else. Oh, and the students have been working really hard on Infinite Space. If you have time, I know it's a really busy time of year, but come down for the readings and the explanations for Infinite Space at 7 o'clock tonight. I think you'll see that this is something that's going to be beautiful for years to come. So please come and check that out. So, we started this last year, and it was fascinating. The reading tonight comes from Romans 8, verse 28. And again, like the covenant prayer, if you were just to spend time, I think this is Molly's like favorite chapter in the Bible, Romans 8. But like this reading, go spend time with Romans 8. But the reading is, and you might be familiar with it, is we know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. And so what these folks have been doing is meditating over the last week about that, and where they've seen it true for their lives, and over the last 4 years here, and where they hope to see it true in their lives for time to come. Sam, I think you had some things to say to start with. Oh, yeah.
All right, so hi, everybody. Okay, I think it's on. Hi, everybody, I'm Sam. I'm one of the seniors of the Board of Stewards here on campus. I just wanted to let everybody know that through my 4 years at High Point and through my 4 years of involvement in the chapel, I've been involved since I was a freshman. My freshman year, the chapel was my first family on campus. And I think that my chapel family has taught me the value of community. Community, especially in the chapel space, is something that's intertwined with God. We find God within community when we give the sign of peace. We find God in the community when we have times of sorrow. But the most important time that we need to see community, and especially the time that I see God in including the High Point community and in our chapel community, is when we have times to celebrate. Being that graduation is near and being that today is the last day of class, it is a time to celebrate. So this is a great space to do so, especially amongst all of your peers here at High Point. I know our seniors are most definitely celebrating today, but I encourage you guys to celebrate with one another and see God through those celebrations.
Sam, you brought up when we met earlier this week, I think we reflected on that phrase from Victor Hugo, right? To love another human is to see the face of God. And you said, like, you thought of Mario from 2 years ago when you were thinking about community and how important this place was, right?
I did. For those who were not here, 2 years ago we had a student pass away on campus, and that was the biggest time that I think I've seen the High Point community come together. And at that moment I realized that High Point University as a family and absolutely pushes God through our students, whether some students may see it, some students may not. But I saw God, especially in my peers at that point. It was a wonderful and very unique experience to see the love and the family feel that was developed within our chapel space.
Just to piggybacking on his story, on what Sam said, it was the worst. Some of y'all who knew Mario really well, he was one of these unique students that had friendships across campus. Like, really unique person to touch lives in places like that you couldn't imagine in terms of... It was odd because when we came for a vigil for him in this space, it was like ADT was here and KA and all these... And he saw all these people coming together from across campus where he had touched lives. What blew me away, and some of you heard this story before, was someone wrote about the passing of the peace from chapel being the most important thing to them. And at first when I was reading this reflection paper, I thought, that's the silliest thing I've ever heard, the passing of the peace being the most important thing. And why she said it was that she came to chapel week in, week out, and she got to know this other student who was in chapel, and they would come to that time of the service where they'd say, peace of Christ be with you, peace of Christ be with you. And it was Mario. And she took this great depth of joy and mystery in God, this love of grace of God, that they got to have that exchange week in, week out. That's amazing. President Quibain's going to give an honorary diploma to Mario's family next Saturday. And you can't imagine how much that'll mean to his family, but also to this place that we've come as sacred ground to meet one another and pass that kind of peace. It's infinite. It's eternal. It's beautiful.
Okay, I'll talk next. again, for the third time, I'm Jordan Green. And I also have been on the Board of Stewards for the past 4 years. And it's just been an experience that I was not expecting coming in as a little freshman. I think back to little Jordan, who wasn't any shorter than me, but definitely definitely less confident and less comfortable. And I wasn't the person that I am today. And I think back to her, and I'm trying to remember the things that have impacted me the most being here in the chapel and being a part of this community. And kind of to go off of what Sam was saying, the community has been the thing that's driven me through these 4 years. And so one little thing that I think back on of these 4 years is the first time that I did the word from the board where I stand up here and ask you guys for all your money. I remember that was terrifying. That was like the worst experience for me ever because I was like, I don't know how am I gonna do this? How am I gonna stand in front of all these people and ask them for something that I wouldn't wanna just, you know, hand out. And I think I've learned through that. Of course, I've gotten a little bit better over the years. And I think that has been kind of the place where I've started to grow and see myself as more of a part of the chapel community because, number one, I got public speaking experience, which is good. You need that. But number two, I've been able to kind of help promote this idea of us as a chapel community, and that's kind of where I want to spend my little time talking to you guys just a little bit is about how, as a chapel, we've worked together to do so many great things in High Point that may not seem like they've been huge deals or big things, but one thing that immediately comes to my mind is, I think last year we were having, the Board of Stewards puts on a Halloween party for the kids at West End Ministries, and we asked if people from the chapel would bring candy, and at our weekly meeting I was like, you know what, no one's going to bring it, it's not going to work out, but we asked anyway, and then we show up to chapel on Wednesday, and there's like 10 bags of candy, and then we get to go to West End and watch the kids like eating all the candy and running around after they've eaten their candy and throwing the trash all over the place. And just seeing the impact that we've had as a group, as a whole chapel, which consists of you guys sitting here right now, but also people who come in here to do homework or people who are walking by the chapel on their way to class or things like that. Just seeing that the little things, like a piece of candy, is what brings joy to a child who maybe wouldn't get that piece of candy. And I've been able to see God through those little things that we do as a community, and that's just been so impactful for me to kind of remember that even though, you know, life gets crazy and classes are hard and finals are coming up, the little things really do matter, and they've made a huge difference. So I think that's probably the biggest takeaway I've had from.
Good evening, everyone. My name is James Austin Brzezinski, and like Sam and Jordan have said, I've been a part of the Board of Stewards for the past 4 years here, and the Board of Stewards, again, like Sam had said, was one of my close families to begin with at my college experience, and I would not be the same person without some of these great people beside me right now. And one way that all the songs in services and outside of services and having local choirs and groups come in and being a part of that service in itself, I've heard through multiple friends and through family members about wanting to bring back groups and just the overall experience that they got from it all was something like no other. I know I would love to have a whole service where it's nothing but music from the past groups and something that I know.
Less preaching is what you're saying. Less preaching.
Yeah, maybe just a bit. Cut down 5-10 minutes.
I see where you're coming from. Okay.
Yeah. But it's definitely, I know something myself, members of chapel choir, and a lot of other students on campus can connect through is music. And another way that I've been really involved through chapel, and I've been able to work through my relationship with God, and I have a small post in Infinite Space magazine, is I'm the guy who posted all the photos after the chapel services. I recently picked up the camera fall semester of 2000.
Yeah, what's that like? You take pictures of everybody in here each week.
Yeah, oh, well, it was quite the process earlier. I didn't even know how to handle the camera or the millions of buttons on the back. But thankfully, through taking photos every chapel service on Wednesday, and through a lot of the bigger services too, like MLK, Black History Month, even the Lessons and Carol service as well, just being a part of the service and being able to capture everything through there was just mind-blowing to me. And at first I really didn't know exactly what or how to shoot the photos, but as I got better, more experienced, and actually what exactly I'm trying to capture, I think per service I usually take around 200-300 photos and then post around 10 and keep around 5 personally to myself that really just speak volumes and speak words to me. And if you'll check out the magazine, I have several photos in there that are near and dear to my heart. A couple of our Preston Lexi on Ash Wednesday, a couple of our the chapel outside with the sun setting. Others are gag photos of the all of the board just hanging out, and several are of the chapel choir. And this is one way that I've been able to really see the image of God through the others, through the pictures that I take, and be able to share them with the entire High Point and social media community. And I know that in the coming years, Blair and Matthew will be able to take over this position very well.
Yeah, so. It's always amazing to look at them on Friday or Saturday and to see y'all in these images. And I want to be respectful because we're doing some sacred things, but like there's an image from last year where we had a foot washing service outside, and I think it's somebody holding someone's feet. And it was this, it seems like some might think it's off-putting, but it's just such a vulnerable and humble place. It might have been Jordan doing it.
I'm not touching anybody's feet.
it was a reenactment of the Holy Week of Jesus with the disciples. And so James Austin's been able to capture these really holy moments, like moments where people are walking on sacred ground. I've been really grateful for it.
Thank you.
Lexi, what's been most important to you?
Oh, man. Well, some nostalgia is definitely hitting as I'm sitting here looking at all of you guys, thinking about graduation. What are we at, 10 days? Something like that? Yeah. Raise your hand if you are not a senior. Yeah, okay. All of you enjoy this, okay? Enjoy every moment you have, because I can't even begin to tell you how fast it flies by. And I'm so thankful for this High Point community and chapel and Board of Stewards specifically. It's definitely given me the chance to have a family and grow my own faith journey. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I struggle with my faith journey a lot. You know, I went to church every Sunday growing up, and I kind of just sat through there and just kind of went through the motions, and it wasn't personal to me. And so I came here and I joined the Board of Stewards because my sister was on it, and I was like, let's just see what happens. And I fell in love with that. I fell in love with the people, I fell in love with the leadership, and I've just been so thankful. And I've learned so much about myself and about life and about God and about my faith. And so I hope that all of you that just raised your hands can continue to walk in that path and to walk in the light of Christ and realize what your faith journey is and what it has to offer. One of the biggest things I think I learned was just to trust in God. I, for the longest time, wanted to control everything in my life, whether it was friends or internships or jobs. And I would call my mom crying, like, Mom, I'm not getting any jobs. Like, what am I doing? And she's like, just trust in God. I'm like, God is not filling out my applications, Mom. Like, you don't get it. and she and Preston and everybody was like, you just got to trust. Trust in Him. Trust that He has a plan for you that is completely different from my plan that I had for myself. But it's been such an amazing experience, and He delivers. 10 out of 10, 12 out of 10. You know, He is there, and you just need to enjoy the time that you have with each other and in this community, and trust in that. Trust in yourself, and trust that the Lord is going to take care of you, and He's got a bigger and better plan with better people than I could have ever even imagined. And so I'm just thankful for that.
I want to actually say something, but I want to piggyback on this. I think what I love about what Lexi's saying too is reflective of this quote from Oliver Wendell Holmes that I've fallen in love with over the years. And he says that I wouldn't give a fig for simplicity on this side of complexity, but I would give my life for simplicity on the far side of complexity. And like Lexi came up with saying, like, trust God is on the far side of complexity for her. She's wrestled. She's wrestled with big questions, what it means to follow Jesus in this world, and not always having the right answers for it or easy answers, but coming in toward the end of her senior years, the trust. It sounds like the simplest thing in the world, or maybe if you're on the near side of complexity, it may sound too simplistic, but on the far side of complexity, when you've gone through some things, it's a really beautiful statement, right? Like, so when I graduated from seminary, I've said this a couple times, we spent a lot of time getting really smart, how to tear apart people's arguments really well, and it wasn't holy at all, or like it wasn't wise. Like it was a. But at the end of the day, we got to our commencement, and the president, I thought she was going to say something grand about what it meant or something really complex, but what she said was, follow Jesus. Like, wherever you go, follow Jesus, and that'll be the right path. And it was this simplicity on the far side of complexity. It was trust. That's a prayer for you. Yeah. Follow Jesus. Thanks for letting me talk more.
Hey, everyone. My name's Ashley Russell, and I am not on the Board of Stewards, but I've been coming to chapel. I think I've only missed like two or three whenever I thought I was too busy, you know, to come, whenever I thought life was too much. But what's the important thing with that is knowing I've done chapel choir most of my time here, and really and truly making the time to come here, this becomes one of like your safe spaces on campus, and it's consistent in your life, which is something that's really important whenever you're in college, because things are changing at such a fast pace and all. But knowing that you have this space to come into, and you'll see familiar faces and also new people, go introduce yourself. You'll never regret being the friendly person, because I think that's one of the things that makes these services so special, is just being able to connect with people in all, you know, different groups and all different like paths of life while you're here. And if you ever get a chance to come up here and speak and lead a prayer or lead a hymn or do something, do it, because it's also one of those things. It's putting yourself out there in a way that's going to let God work through you, and that's what's the most humbling thing, I think, is just letting him, letting yourself be the vessel so that, you know, he can speak and he can make other people see him through you. And let yourself be that person, be the one to say, hey, and join choir. We're really fun. Definitely, like, singing is one of my favorite things to do. I'm a vocal performance major, but I'm really excited because I have committed to do a master's program here. So hopefully if I don't have classes on Wednesdays, I'm still going to be able to come for like 2 years. So cross your fingers, no Wednesday classes with that. But it'll be
there
really
exciting.
There should
have been a roar of like for that, for you being back here.
Yeah, it's exciting though. But definitely, just make this your space and come whenever it's not just chapel time. Come whenever it's like during the day and all, because it's the most peaceful place. I remember me and one of my best friends who graduated last year, we made bread for whenever we had the offerings. And so we came in, it was like 10:30 at night and the bread had just finished and it was after chapel. And like we came in and it was baking right there. We got pictures with it. And it's just one of those fun things of like, make this part of your home on campus, because it really will be a place that you look to with fond memories, and it'll make you feel good. And knowing, you know, God is here all the time, and he's around everywhere, but like especially here. So that's important to recognize that and remember it all. And just enjoy yourself, have fun, and come to chapel, you know?
there's something I want to say on again, piggyback on, yeah, you, but is there other like things y'all want to leave with folks here? Like things that you're like, this is really important that I want you to hear, things that I've learned along the way.
So this is, as I was kind of like I wasn't like preparing super for this, but kind of thinking about what I've been reflecting on over the past 4 years, one thing that just kind of came to mind that I think chapel kind of has helped me realize is that, and also like what Ashley was saying, that like we are the vessel through which God works. And so one of the things that I kind of was just going through my mind was, because he did, as in because God sent his son and he died for us, we can. And I think through chapel, that's been my place to do that. That's been my place to be that vessel and to share the light with everybody else, and not just to be in myself and get stuck in my, you know, my major and my classes and my papers and all of that, but to really kind of take that inner me and push it out to the world and help people. And that kind of goes along with what I was saying earlier with the whole chapel community, but then also touching the High Point community. So something that's just been kind of ringing through my head is, because he did, we can. And that's, that phrase has kind of stuck with me. I don't know if it will stick with any of you, but I think that's kind of gets to the heart of what our job is here on High Points campus and just as people in general.
I thought of something too. While you're here, try not to get involved with drama, which I know is like so easy to do because, I mean, people are dramatic. It's fine. But at the same time, be like Jesus and be the nice person. Go and try to like smile through it. Try to like make friends with people that might not be similar to you, because you're going to learn a lot through those others. And, you know, we are a school that has so much diversity just with all over the country and all over the world. So make friends with people who are not from the same area that you're from. I'm from North Carolina. I'm very southern. You know, I have that. But a lot of my friends are from up north, and then some from Miami and, you know, California, all over the place. So don't just limit yourself to like the type of person that you are. And again, don't be afraid to go and be the first person to say hey, because then you'll have this huge group of friends that you can call on anytime. And that's important to know that you have that that basic group with you all the time.
I'm going to go off of the note of let God lead you towards your passion. College is a time where you will be put in different situations, in difficult situations, in situations that might make you uncomfortable, in situations that might make you want to dance. You don't really know. It's very unpredictable, but God is pushing you towards your passion, and he's pushing you towards something you love and a group of people that you'll be able to call your family and home. So trust in him. Like Lexi said, he's got that plan. Don't surround yourself with that drama, and live and let God, because quite honestly, he will make it happen for you, absolutely.
I want to see Sam dance now.
I'm not going
to
dance.
Yeah.
I will not dance in front of the chapel, not today.
One thing, at least that's been on my mind, just to reflect on all of you all, would be to never be afraid to take those first few steps. I know that over the years, I've had to pry some of my friends to either to be a part of the choral program or just even to get into chapel, and I know as soon as they started coming to a couple services, they were like, this is fantastic. I don't know what I've been missing. This is great. I mean, and it's not just chapel. It's other groups that I've been a part of, and just anything that you can get involved in. I mean, whether you're hesitant or not feeling anything about it, never hurts just to take those first few steps and just to push that initiative forward. Because you can always look back and say, I wish I did, but looking back and saying, I'm glad I did it. So now I'm a better person for it.
Wow, you guys really took all the good advice over here. Let's see. I think my biggest advice would be to know that it's okay to not know. It's okay to not have it all together or to know exactly what you're doing or where you're going. Back to, you know, just trusting in the process and trusting the Lord that he's going to help you figure that out. I mean, obviously, you got to take the right steps to get there and to set yourself up for, you know, the right direction. But it's okay. Like, you're going to be fine. You don't have to have everything figured out as long as you're open. And you open your heart to people and you open your heart to the Lord, I think that everything falls into place. So you're going to be fine.
yeah, you don't need them. Yeah, I guess last thing. Can I say one more thing? Yeah. Is that right with you?
No.
So when I think about the space, I'm reminded of this passage from Exodus, and it's some of you might be familiar with it. Moses hears God speaking, and God says to Moses, "Take off your shoes. You're on holy ground." And there's this burning bush. Well, Moses has been walking this area for years. Like, it's not new ground. It's that he's been walking the sacred ground forever. So the question that we think about shouldn't be, has this bush just started burning, or has it been burning all along? The ground just didn't become sacred. It's been sacred all the time. And I think, like, when we find holy places like this, when they're at their best, they're a reminder that he is there everywhere, not just here. The sacred ground is everywhere. And the reason I bring this up is that I see, like, Matt Warwick here, and I see, I know Rebecca Verde has been here, who leads Catholic Campus Ministry, or Molly, who's been a leader in college life. Like, there is sacred ground beyond this place, and when this place is at its best, it gives us eyes to see beyond this place, to see, like, to become, as Jesus would say, to become like a child, not childish, but childlike, to be in awe and wonder, because it is all grace. This is holy ground to remind us that it's all one big holy project, and we get to take part in it. Y'all, what a gift. Like seniors, you get to take part in that as you leave this place. If you're still here, you get to take part in that. And every day you get to repractice that covenant prayer. Lord, not me, but you. I guess Sydney, you're in the back. Sydney, who's led Genesis Gospel Choir for years.
The holy ground is all over this place. And when we're at our best, it's just that our eyes are open. So that's my prayer for all of you. Your eyes be open. It's everywhere. Would y'all give these folks a round of applause? Dr. Dobler, would you come up? So we're going to recognize our senior board of stewards members and senior choir, and then after that I'd love if there's any other seniors, if y'all would come up, and we're going to have a commissioning prayer for you before we have our last song by Collision. Go ahead.
Okay, so it is my honor to present a cord to a senior who has been in, we present cords to people who have been in chapel choir for 6 semesters or more. Graduating seniors, and it takes a lot of dedication and time to participate in chapel choir, being here at chapel every week and giving their all during the choir rehearsals, and I can't think of anyone who is more exemplary of that than Ashley Russell. She has truly been a gift to not only to the chapel choir, but also the chapel service. When she's been a wonderful worship leader, introducing the hymns and leading you in song. And she also just has the most wonderful heart. And you do see, she's one of those people, you do see God when you see her face and when you talk to her and hear her sing too, right? Yeah. So I present Ashley her cord.
Yeah, would y'all stand up? And to all you seniors, y'all know that y'all are a really special group to me. We got here at the exact same time. You've put up with me, especially when I had that red beard that I started with when I got here. I don't know what that was. Stephen, you keep things to yourself. So I'm really grateful to this group. This isn't all the senior board of stewards, but as much as they've grown, I feel like I've done the same. And that's because of you. You've been a teacher to me as much, so I'm grateful to all of you. So Lexi, thank you. James Austin, thank you. Sam, thank you. Jordan, thank you. Seniors, if you're in here, would you come up? Matt, y'all, other folks, come on up. Y'all, come on down here. Let's get in a circle. And as you feel comfortable, if you just reach out your arm in a posture of prayer to these folks as we say a prayer over them. Gracious God, as you've said to those who go before us, you've said in Prophet Jeremiah, seek out the ancient paths, the good paths, and walk in them, and your soul will find rest. May it be so for these, your servants here, and those who come after them. May they walk in the ancient paths, your paths, that are full of goodness, righteousness, and mercy, the way of Christ. Guide them and bless them. You are always with them, so we don't ask for your presence with them, but their awareness of your presence, that they might see they are passing by holy ground all the time, and that they can be light in the world in your presence. In Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Give these folks a round of applause.
When it's coming upon you.
Amen. So at the end of the day, simplicity on the far side of complexity. Follow Jesus. He will guide you in the good paths, and He will give your soul rest. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May He make His face shine upon you, and may your soul indeed have rest. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. And God will reign.